السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. يقول ربنا جل وعلا في الحديث القدسي: يا عبادي إني حرمت الظلم على نفسي وجعلته بينكم محرما فلا تظالموا. In the hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, as narrated by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah has made a declaration: O my servants, I have made wronging you or oppressing you illegal upon myself, and I hereby decree it to be illegal amongst you. Do not oppress one another, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us. And the Quran is full of all these commandments about people not wronging or oppressing one another, and the call for justice. And as we have all witnessed yesterday, a much anticipated trial and a verdict that has resulted in what most people would say what took place was part of justice. And in the hadith it said that one time the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال اجتمع النبي sallallahu alayhi wa sallam مع مهاجرة الحبشة. The Prophet, peace be upon him, one time gathered and he was in an assembly with the people who migrated initially to Abyssinia. They left Mecca because of the oppression. They lived in Abyssinia for about 9 years. And then they came back and the Prophet ﷺ is meeting with them. And then he said to them, حدثوني عن أعاجيب ما رأيتم في أرض الحبشة. Tell me about strange things that you have seen or witnessed in the land of Habasha, Abyssinia. فقال فتية. So some young men said, Prophet of Allah, one time, كنا جلوس. We were sitting. فمرت بنا راهبة من عجائزهم. Said, as we were sitting, an elderly nun passed by us. تحمل في رأسها قلة فيها ماء, while carrying a vessel of water on her head. قال فجاء فتى من خلفها. When a young man came from behind her, فوضع يده بين كتفيها ودفعها. He placed his hand between her shoulders and he pushed her. فوقعت على ركبتيها. Elderly nun fell on her knees. انكسرت قلتها. Her vessel broke. وانسكب ماؤها. And the water was gushed. She gathered herself. ثم التفتت إليه. Then she looked back at him. وقالت يا غدر. She said, you treacherous traitor. I love this statement. She called him treacherous traitor because a real man does not come to a woman like this. A real man doesn't do that. So she said, ya ghudar, you traitor. غدن ستعلم. Tomorrow you will know, she said. إذا تكلمت الأيدي والأرجل. When the hands and the feet shall speak, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sets his throne, ستعلم مكاني ومكانك. You shall know about my case and your case when we stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was so moved by the story, and what does he say? Sadaqat. Sadaqat. Twice he said, that woman spoke the truth. That woman spoke the truth. And then he said, لا قدس الله أمة لا يؤخذ لضعيفهم من شديدهم. He said, a nation will never be prosperous so long that the weak are unable to get their rights from the strong amongst them. In other narrations, he says, لا قدست أمة لا يأخذ الضعيف فيها حقه غير متعتع. A nation will never be prosperous so long that the weak are unable to get their rights while they are afraid not. Because see, they say that the goodness of any society is not to be measured by the self-congratulatory statements that that society makes about itself. But the goodness of any society is to be measured by what does that society give to those who are not able to get by themselves. And the sad part about what is happening is the very people that you rely on to protect you, they become the source of your abuse. That is the sad part. You know, back in the 1980s, there was a rap song, when rap was real music, that was formed to speak against police brutality. There was a line in one of these musical one that says, speaking to the police, they said to the police, "You protect us from the criminals, but who's going to protect us from you? You protect us from the criminals, but who is going to protect us from you?" That is why a reader of the Quran is a lover of justice. You cannot read the Quran and not come out as somebody who appreciates and loves and wants to advocate for justice. But very importantly, my brothers and sisters, also remember what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us. Al-dhulmu dhulumatun yawm al-qiyamah. Wronging others comes in the form of darkness in the hereafter. The idea is, do not be the guilty party. Every morning the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, before he leaves his house, there is a dua that he sallallahu alaihi wasallam would make, four things, and one of them is, وَأَعُوذُ بِكَ أَنْ أَظْلِمَ أَوْ أَنْ أُظْلَمَ. Ya Allah, I seek refuge in you that I be of those who oppress others, or that I be oppressed or wronged by others. لا تظالموا. We cannot be guilty of wronging or oppressing one another. Beginning at home. See, we cannot be watching this stuff on TV and be moved by it, but yet at the very same time, we ourselves are guilty of it. We'll be guilty of that. This is not... Sister once called, she said that one time she was watching the news with her husband when they were watching what was happening in Palestine. A Zionist thug with the butt of his rifle, he was beating on the head of an elderly Palestinian woman. She said, my husband was so moved that he started tearing up and crying because of how horrific that was, and rightly so. She said, I started laughing. Was that funny? Why are you laughing? He screams at her. Said, because last month you kicked me and you broke my rib. But now you're moved by this. يَا أَبَا ذَرْ كَفَى بِكَ عَيْبًا أَن تَجِدَ عَلَى النَّاسِ مَا تَعْلَمْهُ مِن نَفْسِكَ. O Abu Dhar, it suffices to shame you that you be mad at people for that which you yourself, you are guilty of. We cannot be screaming against this type of abuse, but yet we are guilty of it at home. We cannot be saying that we are against it, yet we live it, or the people around us are living it at home. So as we celebrate what just took place, and rightly so, we celebrate what took place. But the most important part is, let us begin at home. If we don't like abuse, if we don't like injustice, let us bring an end to it, beginning with the immediate circle of our influence. And as such, we would not be under this threat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الظُّلْمُ ظُلُمَاتٌ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, that oppressing other people would come in the form of darkness against the people who were perpetrating it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us facilitators for peace and justice. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who promote justice inside as well as outside, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.